YouTube, it's Cram. This is in response to Veritasium's bullet block experiment, so go watch that video before watching this one. Here's my answer, but I'm not 100% sure, so wait until Veritasium's follow-up video. So basically, both blocks went the same height because more energy was lost in the first impact. No matter where you hit the block, there was an equal amount of upwards force. When the bullet hit in the middle, most of the kinetic energy was lost due to sound, heat, and friction, about 99%. This is because the center of mass was where the bullet was shot, so the block had to stay straight when the bullet made contact. This meant the bullet could lodge itself deep inside the block without the block moving out of its way. This compression and splitting of the block used a lot of the bullet's kinetic energy. But when the bullet hit the side of the block rotated slightly since the center of mass was not where the bullet was shot. This meant the bullet could only lodge itself so deep before the block rotated too much for the bullet to go any further. Therefore, the kinetic energy that was previously lost due to lodging itself deep inside the block was now used to rotate the block. This allowed both blocks to reach the same height with the same amount of energy, but one was rotating. You have to remember that the penetration difference is tiny, and the amount of energy required to rotate the block was also very small, which is why small factors can affect the outcome so much. Subscribe if you want more science videos like this. Cram out!